Hey y'all, welcome back to the podcast. It's Coach Amy and Shannon here with me. She's one of my group clients. Shannon, you want to tell them hey?
Hi.
Yay. I'm so glad you agreed to let me interview you. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. I'm excited.
Yay. Okay, let's start out with this because I know you're a little bit nervous, but it's going to be okay. It's going to be all fine. It's going to be all fine. So first of all, you're so beautiful.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh, so pretty. I love your glasses. My glasses too. Love the glasses. Okay, so tell me how you found Southern and Healthy.
Okay, well, I actually found you through a friend. Tiffany Burles introduced me to you. Actually, she introduced me to THM. So that's how I found you. And I was kind of stalking you for a while before I became a client. So I'll tell you all about that through my story. But yeah, so I found you just through the Facebook page and through her, actually. So,
okay. Yeah. Very good. Very good. And so she told you about THM too, right?
Yes. Yes.
Very good. Okay. All right. Now, that might have warmed you up a little bit.
Yes.
That's an easy thing. So tell us a little bit about yourself, please, ma'am.
Okay. I am 42, and I'm married to my husband, Ryan, who is a sergeant for the Kansas City Police Department. We live in Kansas City, Missouri. Yes.
Wow.
And we have three kids. Alexis is 15, Taylor is 12, and Mason is 9. And we adopted him from China.
So, thank you.
Yes. That was one thing that I loved about you too, is that you had adopted your voice. So
yes.
Connection. So,
love that.
And I am a first grade teacher in the Smithville School District here. Yeah.
Wow. Hats off to you, sis. Let me teach grown adult women, not little first graders.
Yeah, we're active always, but it's fun. I love it. Yes.
That's awesome. So do you want to just tell us your story? Because I know you have a really good one.
Yes, it's kind of long, but I'll try to make it short.
I'm ready. It's all right.
Okay. So let's see. Well, starting back kind of before THM, I have a little bit of an issue with food. So growing up, I always just kind of believed that, you know, I was the girl that was just always really skinny and I could eat whatever I wanted and it was no big deal, you know, and I just always was skinny. And so I don't really have a story where, you know, I lost a whole lot of weight, but my story is a bit different. So I felt like, you know, it never really mattered and I could eat whatever I wanted and it was all good. And then, once I had my first child, you know, the weight wasn't coming off as easy and things started getting a little bit, you know, I can't eat whatever I want anymore. You know, it's starting to get, but I could hide it really easy. So I still wasn't ever really overweight, you know, it was just right in the midsection. But I started kind of developing this thought that I was always fat, like no matter how skinny I was, I just was fat and ugly. And I don't really know where that came from. That's just the way I've always felt about myself, honestly.
A lot of people that feel that way about themselves. Yes. So
that's the lie that I, you know, that I just always believed growing up. And so it kind of continued throughout my years. And so I would kind of go through this cycle where I'd go on a diet and I'd lose a lot of weight. And then I would reward myself with food, you know, and then I would gain it back and then I'd do it again. And I did like the keto diet and I did, you know, the low calorie and did all the things. And then something bad would happen. And I'd say, well, it's okay because these bad things are happening to me so I can eat all the food. And then I'd just gain the weight right back. So starting about the summer of last summer, July-ish, 21. Well, take it back, about June is when Tiffany told me about THM. And so I started kind of dabbling a little bit in THM and I read the plan book, but I was really overwhelmed. And then she told me about you. And so I was Facebook stalking you and I was really intrigued. And so, you know, I kind of watched things and I started doing it a little bit, you know, I was doing it, but I wasn't really. And I was doing more of the S meals because, again, I had just gotten off keto. And I lost a lot of weight when I did keto. So I was thinking I need to eat all the S meals. So that's what I was doing.
Right.
And I was making some progress with it, but I wasn't doing it right, you know? And so I started doing that and I was losing a little weight and things were going okay. And then I got the phone call that nobody ever wants to get, that my dad was in the hospital. And now backwards, my dad was diagnosed with Alzheimer's in 2017.
Wow.
So he already had some things going on. And Alzheimer's was progressing as we were going along. And so that night, my brother called and said, he's in the hospital and he has stomach pain and they found a mass. And I was just like, well, you know, dad, he's always saying that something's going to kill him because he always thought, you know, that he was going to die. And so I didn't think anything of it. And then the next morning we went and they told us that he had 1 to 2 months to live and he had pancreatic cancer.
Wow.
So, you know, when you get that kind of news, I mean, your whole world just, I mean, it just stops.
That's right. Yeah.
So from that point on, I basically sort of, I was going in back and forth between my mom's house, you know, caring for him. And I have 2 brothers and a sister. So we were shifting, taking turns. Good. And I'm a teacher. So that was coming in on the first weeks of school, which was really hard. And it was exactly 6 weeks from the time that he diagnosed, from the time he passed.
Gracious.
So I also have celiac disease, so I can't eat gluten.
Okay.
So during that time, people were bringing casseroles and things over, you know, and there was no food in her house. So for the last 2 weeks, I moved into her house basically. And I was living off of chips, chocolate, and wine. That was about it. That was all that was in her house. And I was too lazy to go, you know, make a salad or get anything else, and just decided this was it. And I was, you know what, in my mind frame, I thought, well, this bad thing is happening to me and I deserve to just eat whatever I want. Because if with my relationship with food, it was either, you know, I was going to reward myself when I was doing well, or, you know, bad things are happening to me, so I just get this reward, or, you know, I need to like, or I need to do the opposite and just basically not eat anything so I can get skinny. So that's just my mindset that I had always had. So during that time, we were shifting, you know, taking turns sitting by my dad's bedside. And Tiffany had told me about Buds. And I think that was when fall Buds was coming up. And I was like, well, you know, maybe I should do it. But I was making all these excuses. And, you know, I thought, okay, well, I'll just sign up. So I signed up while I was sitting at his bedside. And then he passed, and it started like, I think, the next week. And so I'm going to tell you truthfully that I did the Buds program kind of, but not really.
Yeah.
So I lurked and, you know, I watched all the videos. I was on every one of the Q&A sessions, but I wasn't following it. You know, right. I learned it, but I didn't do it.
Hey, that's okay.
I learned it all, but I was still doing whatever I wanted. I was crying in my closet, drinking the wine, eating the chocolate, eating the chips. And so that carried on until about December. And then you were doing the 100-day challenge, I think starting in January. And and then the Blooms program was coming out. And I was like, you know what? I've had enough. I can't do this anymore. And you had said some things. And there were a couple other girls in the Facebook page that had said some things. Cindy had said some things that had just made me go, you know, I'm worth it. She said, I'm worth more than this. And I thought, you know what? So am I. And then,
amen. I'm about to cry. Like, I really am. I'm getting a little emotional over here.
Sorry.
Oh, no, it's okay.
And you had made, and this is probably gonna make me cry too. And I think this was later on in the Blooms program, but you had made a comment on one of the sessions about how your dad had said that to you, that he never wanted you to stop THM because, you know, he knew how it made you feel and that it was part of you. And I thought, and I looked up at the sky and I was like, you know, my dad wouldn't want me to be like this. I know that he wouldn't want me to hate myself and to treat my body this way and this temple that God gave me because of something that, you know, of this thing that happened to me, because it didn't happen to me. I mean, there was a reason why, you know, God took him. And he doesn't want me to be like this. You know, he wants me to take care of my body and to treat my body like the temple that it is. And, you know, he wants my kids to grow up seeing me do that so that they can do that too.
Yes.
And again, something changed that night. And I just decided, you know what, no more. So I started on January 1st. And I did the Blooms and I did it full out and I started the 100-day challenge and I've been taken off since then. Now, I mean, have I done it every day 100%? No. I mean, because things happen. But I mean, yes, I am forever changed because of the things that you have taught me, and just, and my whole mindset has changed. And I think that's what makes the difference. So I don't have a big weight loss story, but for me, that was the weight that was lost, was the mindset shift.
I'm really in shock because I did not know how, I didn't know all that. Like, I knew the chips, chocolate and wine story. I knew your dad passed away. That's about all I knew. I'm gonna be honest. So I'm a little speechless right now, which is very rare for me, as Shannon knows. I usually always have something to say. Woo! Wow. Well, you have blessed me. I am so grateful. Okay. I really don't know what to say.
I am grateful for you, and I you have blessed me. I mean, so thank you.
Mercy sakes. Okay. So I want to tell you guys, somebody asked me once, I think they were a little hurt that I have not asked them to be on the podcast. But I do pray about that. And I ask God when I go to make my little list, like I have a list, I'm looking, that's what I'm looking at. If y'all are watching the YouTube, I'm looking at my list up here. And, you know, I pray about that. Like when, like the buds progress post is made, or the blooms progress post, or just somebody mentions something in a live Q&A or whatever, I just kind of take note of those kinds of things. And then when I go to work on my podcast list, I just ask God to, you know, remind me. And you're number one. You're the first one up there. You're the first one. I know you're not actively doing coaching right now, right?
No, I'm not.
Okay. So like, that's not even a thing. Like, you don't have, I mean, one girl, when I contacted her, she was like, I'm not even doing coaching. But you knew that I knew because we had discussed it. And I'm like, that's okay. Like, I want to tell your story. Your story is amazing. And so, wow. That's so good. Okay. Let's talk about some not so heavy things. Is that okay?
Sure. It's okay.
So can you share, let's talk about the celiac. I might've known that, but I didn't remember that I knew that. So a lot of people say I have to be gluten-free because X, Y, Z, maybe they don't have celiacs, but for whatever reason, so I can't do THM, and I look at them cross-eyed. Or I look at my phone kind of like, THM's pretty easy to do, gluten-free. Yeah,
it is.
Can you talk to us about what that looks like in your real world life?
Sure. Well, I don't think it's hard at all, because really most of the recipes are gluten-free. I mean, the only thing I really can't do is like the, you know, the breads and the, like, I mean, there's a couple of recipes like the einkorn flour and things like that I can't use, but I mean, I keep things pretty simple when I do my meal planning, because I'm a teacher and, you know, I don't have time to do a whole lot of things, but, so basically what I do is I will make, I meal plan on Sundays, and I'll make, you know, a bunch of the muffins, like the, Auntie Pearl's muffins are my favorite. So I'll make bunch of those.
So good.
And then like the chocolate banana muffins, I make those. So I just prep like a whole bunch of muffins and freeze them. And then, I'll do like shakes. I'll make a bunch of shakes up and freeze them, and then just take one out each day.
Say that again.
Yeah. I'll make whatever shake I'm feeling like, you know, I'll make a batch of a bunch of different kinds of shakes, just blend them up. I stick them in. I don't know if this is really like sanitary or not, but that's what I do. I stick them in my cups and I freeze them. Then I take one out each morning, let it thaw on my desk, and I drink it for a snack.
What kind of cup?
Like my Yetis, or just my, you know, I mean.
Really? I'm ding-dong. I have never thought to do that.
Mm-hmm. I'll just make like a big double batch of like whatever shake it is that I'm wanting, like the blueberry shake and the strawberry bananas. And like, I'll do two or three different kinds and just pour them in. And yeah, that's what I do. But
you just taught me something amazing.
I mean, I don't know if you're supposed to do it that way, or if it's bad,
I think it's
like sitting in the cup.
Who cares?
That's what I do.
It's fabulous. Do
I'm
it.
Not sick. Oh yeah.
That's right. Proceed at your own caution. It's like swim at your own risk.
Yes.
Freeze your shakes at your own risk. I think it's totally fine to do. And I think it's brilliant. Keep going.
Oh no, you're fine. I don't know. I mean, I don't think that it's really any different than the only thing I have to keep out is like bread. I use the the no carb easy bread, you know, I buy that and then make a bunch up, cut it up, freeze it. So, I mean, gluten wise, I think that would be the only thing that would be different.
So you like the no carb easy bread? Cause there's super like tons of mixed reviews here. Okay.
Yeah.
So walk us through how you do it.
Well, and sometimes I have trouble making it sometimes. So I use the blender method, and just make it in the blender. But sometimes it does sink in a little bit. Like you have to kind of be careful with how long you blend it. And I bake it in the Pampered Chef stoneware. I've had that thing for years.
I think that my problem, because I only tried to make a loaf of bread once, and I think that my pans were too big. So I do think that is a thing.
But yeah, I haven't had too many issues. A couple times it sinks in a little bit, but I can still cut it to where I can save it.
It works out. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it's a little bit smaller than a normal loaf of bread, but but I'm not really a big bread eater anymore. I used to be, but then when celiac happened, I stopped eating bread.
It was fine. Yeah.
Yeah.
So I have, you know, a lot of ladies, when I do the Waza cracker thing, they're like, what can I use? And I say thin stackers, of course, brown rice. And there's a red rice and quinoa. Glenn, do you use those?
I don't. I really don't use crackers. Okay. I just leave that stuff out, really.
Not a big deal.
I don't really use any of that stuff. I am really addicted to the popcorners, but yeah. I have to be careful about those because sometimes I'll eat way too many of those. Yeah. And I know you say corn is fattening for the pigs, you know, but it's what they use to fatten up the pigs. So I have to be careful about those, but otherwise I don't really eat a lot.
Oh my gosh. That is one quote that's quoted too many times. It rings true though. Y'all remembered it.
Every time I eat it, your voice is in my head. So I don't try not to eat too many.
Oh my word. Coach Amy says corn's evil. I never said that. I buy popcorners too.
You did not say that.
You just gotta watch it.
Yeah.
You gotta watch it. Everything in moderation, man. Especially corn.
But I will say that this plan is totally doable without gluten. You can do it. It's
amen. Super. Absolutely. I love it. All right. So you menu plan or whatever once a week. That's excellent. So how does your family do on plan with you making on plan meals?
So they don't follow the plan really, but they will eat the meals. And actually my husband is the cook in the family. So I don't really cook much. I can, I just don't really, he loves to cook. He actually wanted to be chef. So he wanted to go
back up, girl.
Academy instead. I know. So he likes to cook. So he and I will kind of go through and pick out which meals, and they'll eat the tea meals, you know, whatever we make, but they're not really fully on plan, you know, so I will buy other stuff for them too, to have for lunches and snacks and things, but we try to keep it fairly healthy around here.
Good. Excellent. Yeah. Excellent. So how have you done coming off of the chips, chocolate and wine thing? Like, is that something you still kind of fall back to? I mean, is that a question I can ask?
Oh yeah, sure. You know, yeah, sometimes I feel like, you know, I want to eat that stuff, but then I'll just replace it with other things. Like I can eat the popcorners, cause that's kind of like a chip, you know, or the Lily chocolate I can do, you know. But for me, it was more about like, I was eating and drinking, and I wasn't like drinking, like, you know, all the time, but I would just have a glass of wine because I felt like I needed to do it because I was upset. Well, now when I have a glass of wine, it's because, you know, just because I want to, not because I'm upset about things.
Right.
But, so I'm not going to those things anymore because I'm upset or because I'm depressed. It's just, you know, I want to. So I think I've been able to replace that thought of, oh, I need to do this because, you know, I deserve it because these bad things are happening to me, you know?
That's fantastic.
That's
healing that part of your heart it's tough to do, but I mean, you look so joyful.
Thank you.
Do you feel so free? Like that burden? So good.
It took a while, but yes, it's taken a while, but finally. Yeah.
Wow. That's incredible. I'm so proud of you.
Thank you.
I'm so proud of you. Oh my goodness. Okay. Hey, what else do I want to ask you about? Oh, do you exercise?
Yes. So actually, I just started back up again this week. So I got COVID in January, and when I got COVID, it caused this intense vertigo. So I've had vertigo for quite a while, and I haven't been able to exercise. But before that, I was an avid runner, and I ran half marathons. So I'm just
kidding me.
Yeah. Yes. Oh.
So I don't even want to run the 400 meter warm up at CrossFit, and you're running half marathons.
Yes.
It's in some people's blood, and it's not in mine.
Well, it's funny because before that, after I had my second daughter, I hated running, and my husband ran a full marathon while I was pregnant with my second daughter. And I was like, I'm never doing that. And he's like, you should just go try it. It'll help lose the weight. And so I went out one day and I was like, I'm never doing this again. And I fell on the pavement and was like, no. And then I went out again and did it. And I somehow fell in love with it. And I've been doing it ever since. But since I got injured and sick, I hadn't yet for a while. So I'm starting back up again, but slowly.
So do you run, when you are running, do you run like every day? How long? Like, what does that look like?
Well, it's like maybe 3-4 times a week. And then I add in like at home workouts too. So like video thing. Yeah.
Have you done any of my workout videos from Blue?
I have not yet, but I need to, because at the time I was still injured, but I watched. You do some of them.
You watch them? Yeah. So I have a client. I'm a caller out. Oh, Darlene, I love her. So she texts me. She's a one-on-one, and she messaged me and she said, well, I just sat here and drank a couple of cups of coffee watching you exercise, but I never moved from the couch.
That's kind of what I was doing too.
I said, I'm that entertaining that you can watch me work out and go through your coffee. So those workout, just for all y'all listening, those are only for Bloom's clients, because I just can't release it to the general public yet. Oh gosh. They say they're okay and they work. I mean, I have some that do them every week, and y'all are crazy. There's only like 3 videos. But anyway, I don't want to talk about that anymore. That was really hard for me to do. Like, they pushed me to do that. Those Bloom's girls.
They're good. You should do some more.
I don't know. Probably not. Thank you. I'd rather cook.
Well, I like to cook.
When you were stalking me on the Facebook, like, what? I want to know more about this, because people tell me that all the time, and I'm like, what's that mean? What's your round? So tell me about it. Like, what did you like? What did you hate? What sucked you in? All that kind of stuff.
Oh, I did not hate anything.
Shannon.
I just loved everything about you. I loved your personality. I just loved the way that you were just so joyful, and just, you know, everything that you said, just, it was just very, I just always felt like everything, all of the advice that you gave was just very good. You know, just everything that you said was, very beneficial, and it just was great. And I also love the adoption story. I read it, and that really made a connection for me, you know. And I mean, it was just very encouraging. Everything was very encouraging. I just felt like, you know, I just felt like I belonged in that group, you know, even though I wasn't active or didn't really do anything, you know, but I just felt like I belonged there.
Yeah.
And even in Buds, when I wasn't really doing anything either, I just felt like I was a part of the group.
Wow. Well, thank you. That worries me in group coaching. I'll be honest with you. I now have so many in there, but they want to be in the group. And I get a little concerned because I can't call roll every day or check on everyone. It's just impossible. Even when I had 30 in a group, it's impossible to do that. And so I tell them, you know, I'm not check and roll, but I'm showing up. So you show up too. And I wanted to commend you, excuse me. I wanted to commend you for that, because you were coming into a Buds program, probably not knowing what in the world to expect, but you knew me, you felt like you knew me, right? Because a lot of ladies tell me that, because like, I'll do one-on-one discovery calls and I'm like, hey, it's nice to meet you. And they're like, I know all about you. But on my end, I'm like, oh, okay. Because I don't see y'all's lives. Y'all see mine. Anyway, but right. I just want to commend you, because coming into Buds from that place of grief, and still showing up and learning it, even though you weren't implementing, but you didn't feel guilt about that. I mean, you might have, but it wasn't enough to stop you from learning. And I think that's huge. I tell clients that all the time in Buds. I don't know if they hear it, but I don't expect you, and I don't think any other coach would either. I don't expect you to be 100% doing every THM thing when you come into Buds. I want them to learn and use those challenges to create lasting habits to have a sustainable THM journey, right, for your life. And like, I'm just really proud of you for doing that. I didn't know that's what you did. Had no clue. But I'm glad I know now. That's really cool.
I remember thinking, oh, this is not good that I'm just like shoving M&Ms in my mouth while I'm like watching your videos. But you know, eventually it paid off. It just took time.
Yeah. And it does. It takes time for a lot of things. It takes time to heal your heart and your mind, your mental health, and then your body too. Because I'm sure like even with your celiacs, different things can cause inflammation. You could have cross-contamination and things like that. And so you probably have healed your body from those kind of things as well, being 100% trim healthy mama, you know, right, for sure. And, you know, so many women talking about time, they don't give it enough time. They don't give themselves time to learn. And then they don't give their bodies time to heal. And they get frustrated because they haven't lost 20 pounds in a week and they quit. But you have to give it all time. Yeah. I mean, it took you months and months just to heal from years of those negative thoughts that were in your mind about your body image. And you have daughters. How many?
I have two daughters.
Two daughters. So yes, I mean, what you said earlier, you know, that your daddy would want you to be healthy for an example for his grandkids, you know, and your girls and your son, of course, too, but girls are so much more body image, you know, in general. I'm sure dudes, little dudes are too, but you know, thinking about that. So, man, that's so good. So how do they feel about mama running half marathons and putting shakes in the freezer? Like that's blowing my mind. I love it.
Yeah. They actually used to run with me when I was running, but they're still like, what is this stuff in here? Like, you know, the whole thing about me, like, mom, what is this? But you know, they try most of the stuff, but some of it I can't get them on board with. Most of the meals they like, but you know, some of the shakes and muffins and things, they're like, what is this?
Yeah, it is hard. I mean, when you're still having real sugar, you know, it's hard to like that kind of stuff. Fun example today, Wes, you know, he's been on plan for a while, super, super proud of him. But my favorite fruit is mango. Like I love it. And so I was having some with my lunch today and I said, do you want some mango with your lunch? He was like, I don't like mango. I went, do not speak that blasphemy in my kitchen, you know? And I said, okay, I'm about to give you the best piece of the mango. So, you know, you cut it on each side of the seed or whatever it's called. The pit. I don't know the real word of the mango. I'm sure somebody will let me know what it is, but anyway, so in the very center on each side, that's the best piece in my opinion. And so I said, I'm gonna give you the best piece of the mango. So I gave it to him on a little toothpick and he was like, I think that first time I tried mango, it must've been a bad mango. That's good. Oh, so he ate the other half. He was so excited. So another thing is he could have been so used to real sugar from all the things he would have all the time that he couldn't appreciate the mango for what it was. I don't know, but it could also have been a not so good mango, but yeah, people just got to give it time.
Yes.
So what other self-care things do you do besides the exercise and doing Trim Healthy Mama, especially as a busy teacher and mom?
Yeah, it's hard. I try to make sure that I spend time daily reading the Bible and doing some kind of Bible study. Or right now I'm still reading. I'm That Girl. So I'm working through that book. And I try to give myself, I don't know if this is considered self-care, but time each day with one child. So, awesome. You know, I spend, you know, I've tried to, now that I'm off, it's easier to do, you know, I pick one kid a day and we have like time together. So, I think for me, that's self-care because I don't get to spend a lot of time with each kid individually. That's so brilliant. I'm trying to make time to do that. But,
So what are some things that y'all do together?
So it depends on the kid. You know, my son Mason, he really likes to build like Legos. So
how old is he again?
Nine.
Nine. Okay.
Yes. And making slime was one thing he just said he wanted to do. So we're going to be doing that when we get off the call. We'll see. but you know, stuff like that, just like crafting projects and things. The girls like to go shopping. So we usually do like window shopping or driving around talking or going to get coffee or, you know, things like that.
I love that. That's so precious. Good job, mama. Good job.
Fine.
I love it. All right. Let me see what else I want to ask you about. Let's see. Do you juggle fuels?
Yes, I try to. Like I said before, at first I was all about the S meals. Yep. And I had a really hard time with E's because I had always had in my mind that carbs were bad because right. You know, when I did the keto for so long, I had really good results at the end. But so I have really been trying to do more E meals and try to get at least like one or two in a day. And the fuel pull is hard for me. So this summer I've really been working on getting a fuel pull snack in every day and I'm doing better with that. So I'm trying to get in like at least, you know, one E and one fuel pull a day is what I'm trying to do for now. I'm trying.
Classic little Coach Amy girl.
I'm working on it. So far it's been going pretty well, but you know, so I'm not making my shakes and freezing them now because I'm at home. So I'm trying to make a shake in the afternoon.
Maybe I should. I think you should. Totally do it.
I'd probably do that. But I've been on the quinoa train lately. So it's been really good. I love quinoa. So I've been eating a lot of that lately.
Good. That's awesome. Very good. All right. So let's see. So what other challenges have you come across? Was it, you know, adding in veggies or drinking the water or the timing? What else?
Yeah, the timing, I think, has been hard for me, especially when I'm working, you know, because I have specific times that I have to eat. So that was a little bit hard. And, you know, whenever you try to eat in front of kids, they get, you know, well, why can't I have a snack? You know, so yeah. The timing is hard at work. And I think the emails, you know, have been a little challenging, but it's getting better. And also traveling has been hard for me.
Oh yeah.
So was it last week? Actually, we went to, my husband and I have done, student ministry at our church for years. And so we went to church camp last week,
right?
In Arkansas, and I was not able to pack food because we were going on a 6-hour bus ride and I couldn't bring a cooler. So yeah. I had to eat what they had there and it was all carbs. And now she did prepare gluten-free meals for me, but I could totally tell a difference when I came back. My body just felt, you know, you can tell when you go off for a week and then you come back and it was, so, you know, when you can't bring your food with you, like I just couldn't do it. And it was, this week has been, I can just tell like the moment I came home and I was like, well, thank you for my, you know, GGMS and my quinoa and my, cause it's just, it was rough. You know, you can tell when you've been off for like 4 days of just hot dogs and carbs and, you know, yuck.
Wow.
So traveling. Ooh,
I don't know that I could have chaperoned that trip. Yeah. That'd have been hard for me.
She's like, well, I don't think you can bring stuff. All right, well, I'll just make it work. And I tried, but there was like no salad. There was no, like, you know, you just have to make do. So that was definitely a challenge. So.
Yeah. Bless your heart. Wow. All right. Well, thank you so much. Oh my gracious. This has been incredible. I want to know if you have any advice for any new Trim Healthy mamas out there, just to encourage them, because, you know, you had a little rough start. Because you were brand new, you haven't even been doing THM for a whole year yet, you know, and so I think it's incredible the progress that you've made in that short amount of time.
I would say, first of all, just know that you are worth it, that you are worth the time and you are worth the effort. And also just know that it is, I always tell myself it's a marathon and not a sprint, that it takes time. And, you know, not to expect the pounds and inches to just fall off, because, you know, it takes time. And just that you are worth more than the chocolate chips and wine. That's what I just tell myself. Yeah. You know, I mean, that might not be your thing, but just that you're worth it. I mean, I just, and just to trust the process, because it does take time, you know. And I know I used to get stuck on like getting on the scale, and I know that's why that's always your first thing, is ditch the scale. Ditch that scale, because I would get on every morning and be like, it hasn't moved. That you don't need that scale, because that's not what it's about.
That's right. Amen. That was so good. Good job.
Thank you.
Super good advice. All right. Well, thank you so much. I hope everybody has a wonderful summer. It's so hot here. Is it hot at your house?
Very. Like
is it heat index? I would just call it like 110 here today. Golly Moses. So hot. What state are you in? I don't know if you said.
Missouri.
Okay. Yes. My client I just talked to, she just went to Missouri to a family reunion. Yep. And she said it was crazy hot.
Yes.
Yes. All right. Well, thank you again. I'm going to tell everybody bye. You want to tell them bye?
Bye.
Bye, y'all.